I declare the commencement of the ceremony for the conferment of degrees, session 4.
Honorable Chairman, I present candidates from the School of Business and Administration for the awards as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet, Session 4.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate from the School of Business and Administration for the awards as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet, Session 4.
Bachelor of Business, Honours in Accounting. Annie Kong Siu Len.
Congratulations. Come to take a picture.
Bong Jun Chin. Chai Wui Li. Chia Lai Man. Chia Pik No. Chin Fung Leng. Zhong Tian Tian. Eric Yi Jing Sheng. Evelyn Chen Lai Cheng. Feng Si Kei. Hema M. Sandivelu. Hugh Kai Ying. Hugh Siu Ping. Ho Suk Ping. Ho Si Jin. Im Marie Ong. Kalevani Krishnan. Ko Pei Guan. Kyok Si Wei. Kok Hui Shuang. Kong Sut Wei. Quan Miao Teng. Li Ka Yi. Li Kok Han. Li Mei Yin. Li Pek Shen. Leong Ban Kit. Liao Huai Ping. Lim Guat Shu. Lim Mei Yen. Lim Pei Ying, with distinction. Lim Pui Shan, with distinction. Lin Wei Chun. Logita Mutusami. Lo Fu Hong. Lo Yi Si. Lui Wai Wai. Mina Karupia. Ng Swet K, with distinction. Nur Hafifa Huhaizat. Nur Diana Muhammad Abu Bakar. Ong Chi Hong. Ui Kui Xuan. Ui Su Sen. Periyanagi Subramaniam. Pu Hui Teng. Premawadi Gunasegaran. Priya Sakti Raman. Ramit Yap Ping Siong. Shireen Tan Hui Leng. Sim Hui Che. Sivaranjini Kunalan. Susan Tan Sok San, with distinction. Sudhakaran Subramaniam. Shifa Nazira Muhammad. Tai Chun Wei. Tan Bi Yan. Tan Yik Sing. Teo Chia Poon. Tian Fu Chun. Ting Pei Chin. Vigneswari Ramanathan, with distinction. Wong Miao Xiang. Wu Ziyin. Yap Chun Chi. Yap Mei Shan, with distinction. Yap Si Bei. Yi Bei Wen. Yip Miu Ling. Yolanda Tang Jermaine. Bachelor of Business Honours, Corporate Administration. Bong Yat Ngo, with distinction. Camellia Xiao Jia Wen. Song Sit Fei. Elaine Jia Wan Jing. Kam Hong An. Kumuda Viria. Te Pei Fen. Bachelor of Business Honours in Entrepreneurship and Small Business Management. Zhong Gong Hao. Chua Ming Fei. Han Yin Xin. Justin Go Kok Hoon. Ng Wai Leong. Tam Han Chong.
Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Dr. Koh Soo Koon, Chairman of the Board of Governors, Wawasan Open University, and Chairman of the Wawasan Education Foundation. My colleague, Professor Zoraini, Deputy Vice Chancellor of Wawasan Open University, distinguished guests, faculty, staff, graduates and family members, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of WOU, congratulations. It is my pleasure to welcome all of you to our 10th convocation ceremony this morning. This year is special for WOU. We have the largest number of graduates graduating from WOU, 740 of you from the Schools of Business Administration, which has the highest number of graduates. All of you are here. The School of Science and Technology, the School of Humanities and Social Sciences, and the School of Education, Languages and Communication. It is also a special year for me because I'm giving my inaugural speech as your Vice Chancellor at this occasion, having joined WOU 7 months ago. Now, 163 of you are from postgraduate programs, 577 of you from the undergraduate programs, and you are all between 22 to 76 years young. 59% of you are women, 41% of you are men, and I can understand that from this morning's session. Welcome and congratulations to all of you. We at WOU are very proud to have you as our student, and after today, you will be, and you are now part of the 4,500 alumni at WOU. You are amongst a group of university graduates who have gotten your degrees while working via distance learning, using technologies to enable you to access your course contents and communicate with your faculty and tutors. You are indeed amongst a special group of adults in Malaysia who have received your degrees this way. Indeed, the future of education will increasingly rely on such distance learning platforms, which means you work, you earn, you study for a degree, and you get a degree like today. WOU is proud to have such a diverse group of you. Many of you are executives and managers of various industries, engineers, auditors, to-be accountants, bankers, lecturers, teachers, secretaries, supervisors, technicians, IT executives, and so on. This convocation marks a new chapter in your life. Whether you continue to study with us, please come back and apply for the Masters of Business Administration, or you build your own careers and become valuable employees, go on to get your professional certifications, because many of you are from accounting, or become employers someday. And I see we have entrepreneurship graduates also. So we look forward to all of you doing different things. And I urge each and every one of you to continuously build a sustainable community and facilitate personal growth and development. This is lifelong learning. WOU is also going through a period of transformation to ready itself of what's to come. We are at the precipice of another global shift within the next 5 to 10 years. Up to 375 million people globally will need to find entirely new kinds of jobs by 2030. Because of automation. How workers, governments, and businesses tackle these seismic shifts will define the future of work. We have to be geared for this change at WOU
by continuing to evolve new course contents, continuing to adopt new learning platforms to stay relevant to attract students like yourselves. Our tagline right now is Think Tomorrow. This is because we are striving to build the nation's talent pool that automation cannot replace. WOU has already found its right footing by being one of the pioneering institutions offering open distance learning in Malaysia at a time when the cost of traditional tertiary education is escalating around the world. As the world readies for the fourth industrial revolution, universities have to gear up and prepare a creative workforce that supports new fields such as artificial intelligence, innovation, automation, data analytics, machine learning, and so on. We must not just be aware, but know how best to manage all these upcoming technological advancements that are expected to impact all aspects of our lives and industry. In order for higher education to deliver future generations with the right set of skills and knowledge, an imperative question has to be asked regarding how higher education institutions would be affected by Industry 4.0 and how the delivery of education will be transformed. We are gearing for this shift and will be rolling out a new set of exciting initiatives in the next year. Conversations around the Internet of Things, or IoT, is currently taking place all over the world as we seek to understand how this will impact our lives. Universities are also trying to understand the many opportunities and challenges we are all going to face as more and more devices start to join the IoT. For now, the best thing that we can do is educate ourselves about what the IoT is and the potential impacts on how we work and live. Institutions of higher education can no longer conduct their business as they have in the past. The changes associated with IoT have to be managed in order to ensure effective and immediate transformation. In a recent public address, our Prime Minister, Tun Dr. Mahathir, raised this point and added that while change and disruption are the new normal, talent and their developmental needs continue to be vital. He also said that there is a need to transform our human capital, both the existing workforce and students, by equipping them with new skills, innovative thinking, and multidisciplinary knowledge. We at WOU want to play a role in shaping innovation and educating future generations in Malaysia. Therefore, we are placing ourselves in the forefront of the much-needed debate and conversation about shaping the future of universities and imparting programs in an adaptable, flexible, and relevant social environment to ensure that the world's population, both young people and adults, have the means to pursue lifelong learning. After all, WOU's mission is to transform higher education through open distance learning. The role of higher education is broadly defined as one of the key drivers of a nation's growth performance, prosperity, and competitiveness. Its focal points comprise its intellectual function, which is teaching and research, and also its educational function, cultivation of the mind, transmission of basic ideas and concepts. Another often forgotten role is its societal impact. Educating citizens who will be more engaged in their communities through civic activities and public discourse, and in developing leaders who will contribute to the advancement of business,
organizations and society. Universities, therefore, have an important role in basically building good human beings. Our country's continued prosperity depends on an educational system that produces an educated community that understands and values our democratic system of government, appreciates the complexity of our country's different cultures, and the benefits of upholding these hard-fought relationships, while also recognizing the importance of being at the forefront of innovation and research. It is also important to note that a culture of inclusivity helps to drive innovation and creativity, widen the institution's worldview, and increases productivity. Establishing an inclusive culture must be a priority of senior leadership at all institutions. This is critical for not only with strong, successful, and innovative universities can a nation's economy be bolstered, and we are able to shore up Malaysia's position in the global hierarchy of power. One of my main duties as WOU's Vice Chancellor is to prepare the university for the Generation Z or Z students. Young adults who are growing up in a highly sophisticated media and computer environment and are completely internet savvy. We need to be ready for the influx of industrious, collaborative, and entrepreneurial learners. This is a generation in a woke state, in case W-O-K-E, woke. In case you're not aware, this word has just been added to the Cambridge Dictionary, and it means to be alert to injustice in society, especially racism. This is the generation of inspiring young people like Malala Yousafzai, the Pakistani activist for female education and the youngest Nobel Prize laureate. Greta Thunberg, the climate change crusader. Again, another woman, right? Jack Cable, a rising star in the world of white hat hackers. Cybersecurity, he can hack in. For a good cause, not for a bad cause. If it's bad cause, they're called black hat hackers, okay? And even closer home in Indonesia, the sisters Melati and Isabel Wixon, who launched a project called Bye Bye Plastic Bags to raise awareness about the issue. Change is coming, and this new generation of students from Generation Z is leading it. This presents a significant challenge to university leaders who need to be prepared for the clash of the three generations. I would say four generations or five generations, but first X, Y, and Z, each with their own outlook and habits. And because we are an open distance learning university, the baby boomers generation are also now coming back to us. So how do we come up with curriculum and content that can accommodate all generations? And it's lifelong learning. To the graduates today, I urge you to live with purpose by embracing a strong sense of service and an emphasis on ethics and values in a rapidly changing world. Forget the labels we unkindly place on one another. Just know that you are part of a learning community that truly spans cultures, backgrounds, and religions. We hope that you will continue to be a part of the WOU family and give us your feedback to help us identify our strengths and weaknesses while influencing future improvements. Be proud of your achievements, but at the same time, be thankful to your parents. They brought you here. Family, friends, colleagues, and employers especially, who have made it possible for you to take this educational journey. In conclusion, I once again offer my congratulations to all the graduates from this session. Thank you very much.
Professor Lily Chan, Chief Executive and Vice Chancellor, Professor Zoraini Wati Abbas, Deputy Vice Chancellor, faculty and staff, graduates and family members, Dif-dif jemputan saudara-saudari yang saya hormati sekalian. Selamat pagi, tajia hao, wanakum. I am indeed very happy and greatly honored to preside over the fourth session of the Wawasan Open University's 10th convocation ceremony this morning. First of all, I wish to congratulate all the 84 recipients of the Bachelor of Business Honours degree in this session. I'm sure each and every one of you, your family and friends, are truly proud of you and your achievement. Today marks a major milestone in your journey of life. Give yourselves a big hand. This year marks the 12th anniversary since WOU as Malaysia's first private not-for-profit university for adult learners first opened our doors to part-time open distance learning or ODL students in 2007, and then to school leavers pursuing full-time on-campus learning in our Penang main campus right here, starting 2013. To date, more than 24,000 adult and young learners have experienced WOU's mode of learning, both ODL and OCL, with about 4,500 having successfully obtain degrees, diplomas, and certificates, including all of you present here this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, WOU became a reality through the visionary dedication and legendary drive of Parti Gerakan's third president, the late Tun Dr. Lim Keng Yek, and the generosity of the Yap Chor E family in Penang, as well as many corporate and individual donors. Tun Keng Yek first mooted in 1999 the idea of an open online university giving a second chance for higher education to working adults. With the vesting of assets from the Yap Chor E Endowment Trust, effected by Yap's grandson, Datuk Sri Stephen Yap, the Gerakan Education Foundation was converted into a new entity, the Wawasan Education Foundation, which then sponsored WOU. Tauke Yap Chor E, who started as a barber assistant on arrival in Penang from China, penniless and uneducated at age 17, epitomized the legendary story of rags to riches. Using his client connections, he soon moved into grocery, trading of rice, sugar, rubber and tin, and eventually set up Penang's first local bank, the Ban Hin Lee Bank. Being illiterate himself, he valued education and donated generously to schools, temples, and the establishment of University of Malaya. He set up an endowment trust with a will, bequeathing a number of his properties for education, including this majestic homestead, which has become WOU's iconic headquarters. Amongst the various corporate donors to WEF, the one giving the biggest amount was Tan Sri Syed Mokhtar Al-Bukhari, who paid for the 12-story office block behind Homestead. That's where we are now. Born into a poor family in Kedah, Syed Mokhtar stopped schooling after Form 5 to help his father full-time in farming vegetables and breeding cows. He then moved on to meat packaging, rice trading, logistics, etc., which eventually grew into a big conglomerate of diverse interests. He has also been donating generously to education. I highlighted briefly here the struggle of Tauke Yap Chor Yee and Tan Sri Syed Mokhtar because they are indeed role models in entrepreneurship and corporate management for all of us. They started with no education or just basic education, without a bachelor degree in business administration or any other field, and yet they managed to overcome so many obstacles, excel so well, and achieve top business leadership. Ladies and gentlemen, in his address in the first session of the convocation yesterday morning, our Chancellor, Tunku Imran Jaafar, advised that in today's world, quote, it is vital for those in positions of leadership in business, government, civil society to demonstrate openness and transparency, unquote. He also said, quote, transparency makes good business sense since it enhances customer trust and confidence, builds customer loyalty, and promotes customer satisfaction, unquote. Our Tunku Chancellor is indeed a household name in Malaysia for his leadership excellence in sports promotion, corporate management and entrepreneurship, civic service, education and charity. I presented the above two quotable quotes from his speech for you to refer and use. This is because all of you, as successful Bachelor of Business Honours degree recipients, are now poised for a new phase of your career path and for new opportunities where you are likely to assume higher leadership roles, presumably mostly in the business world. If I may, I would like to add that a leader must always be committed to lifelong learning so as to keep up with information explosion and rapid changes brought about by technological disruptions of industrial revolution or IR 4.0. Actually, the concept and practice of lifelong learning is not new. The Greek statesman and philosopher by the name of Solon, over 2,600 years ago, was well known for saying that, quote, I grow old learning something new every day, unquote. The great Italian Renaissance artist of the 15th century, Michelangelo, was quoted to have said many times at age 87, I am still learning. Many of you may know the popular Chinese saying, 活到老, 学到老, meaning to live and learn until old age. Also, 学无止境, meaning there's no limit to learning. Muslim scholars in Nusantara or the Malay archipelago in ancient times have always advised, belajarlah walaupun ke negeri Cina, that is, seek knowledge even by going to China. It highlighted the determination to learn, because at that time, going to China was a tedious and treacherous journey by land or by sea. This year, amongst the 740 graduates, there are 4 septuagenarians. Some bombastic word. It means that those who are aged over 70 years, like myself, receiving their WOU degrees at this convocation. The eldest is Madam Camelia Tan Abdullah, age 76, of Johor. She received her scroll yesterday, okay? Receiving the Commonwealth Executive MBA, Mr. Kor Choi King, age 73, of Johor. He will receive his Bachelor of Business Honours in Sales and Marketing in the next session. Madam Magaya Karasi, age 71, of Johor. All 3 from Johor, eh? So Penangites better catch up. Madam Wong Siu Chi, age 72, of Kuala Lumpur. Both of them received the Master of Education degrees during the first session yesterday. Madam Wong has just enrolled herself, remember her age, 72, for WOU's Doctor of Business Administration, or DBA, program. So there's no reason that you should not do it. They are indeed exemplary lifelong learners. Another exemplary lifelong learner is this year's Tun Dr. Lim Chong Yu Memorial Prize recipient, Mr. Che Fu Sun, age 41, a Master of Education degree recipient. However, he has earlier obtained 3 degrees from WOU. SEMBA, the Commonwealth Education MBA, in year 2010. He was our first batch of graduates, okay? Graduate Diploma in Sales and Marketing in 2013, and Bachelor of Business in Sales and Marketing in 2016, all from WOU. So 4 votes of confidence in WOU. I told him yesterday that he should enroll in the DBA program so he can say, give me 5. Ladies and gentlemen, besides commitment to lifelong learning, it is crucial to have a positive mindset while carrying out your job and responsibilities after graduation. A prominent Confucian scholar, journalist, and political reformist in China at the turn of the 20th century, Mr. Liang Qichao, wrote a short essay entitled "Jing Yue Le Yue," which means respect your job, enjoy your job. I find this short essay highly relevant and very useful as a guide for myself, and I would like to share it with you. According to Mr. Liang, we have to be respectful and indeed grateful for whatever we are doing and are paid to do. Depending upon your religious belief, being grateful means that you accept your job and responsibility as taqdir, that is God's will, or karma, causes and effects of deeds in cycles of life. However, without even referring to any religious belief, you can look at it as accepting and honoring the responsibility entrusted to you in whatever position you are in now, as long as you are still in that position. Enjoying your job comes quite naturally as a consequence of respecting your job. Quite a number of people quite often feel that they are stuck in whatever they are doing. Even though they may work hard and give their very best, they feel frustrated or even suffocated and not appreciated enough. Even without openly complaining to others, they may in their hearts blame others or even blame their own fates. Life becomes miserable for themselves and also for others who work or live with them. However, if we have a positive mindset towards our job and responsibilities, things usually will click better and work to our advantage. Hence, being responsible at the workplace doesn't merely entail achieving the KPIs or key performance indicators of each and every piece of work assigned to us in a procedural and mechanical way. It should be more than that. It is to bring a good heart, mind, and soul to our workplace. It is having the welfare of our colleagues at heart and also our customers at heart. It is working closely and happily with everyone towards the success of our organization for all to benefit. Our workplace will then be a pleasant place for all of us to look forward to. It will then be truly enjoy the job for ourselves and our colleagues. Happy and positive thinking people working together are usually more productive, more effective, and even more innovative. In conclusion, I trust that after your WOU experience, all of you have become lifelong learners, dedicated to acquire more knowledge, more skills, including the soft skills of leadership, with more effective communication and collaboration, with a positive attitude of 敬业乐业. Let us make learning not only a lifelong process, but also our way of life. With that, I once again congratulate all of you with best wishes for your future and endeavors. Terima kasih, xie xie, nandri, wanakum, thank you. I now declare the ceremony for the conferment of degrees, session 4, closed.